You have got to get lost. There's something here for you.
She's talking to Noah, but normally she'd be saying those things to
Noah.
Me.
Noah.
That I need to get lost and there's nothing here for me.
Good morning. It just woke up in my slippers still. Goose just had his morning treat. That's right. You look gorgeous on this rug. And we're so happy that we woke up well rested. We have not been sleeping well. And we're just over the moon that we had a good night's sleep because, and by the way, we just have this mirror here. Temporarily, I was taking some photos the other day. I just like needed the mirror there, so I moved it. But we're over the moon because we finally got a good night's sleep. And we haven't really been sleeping well this week. I think it's because we've been too hot in our bed. So I don't know if you guys saw over on stories, I kind of like redid our bedding and I laid like a quilt coverlet over the bedding. And instead of sleeping with like the duvet over us, we slept with the coverlet last night and a little bit of the duvet, and it was like the perfect temperature. And I think what we realized that we were too hot, it was like too many layers, or not too many layers, but I think our comforter cover is maybe not like a breathable one. So, well, I don't know though. I'm not sure, it's really nice quality. It's like from Restoration Hardware. And it was fine, but I think sometimes the sheet and the comforter may be a little bit too much because we've been sweating. We've been putting our AC at like 62 because we've been so hot. So anyways, we finally got a good night's sleep. We're really happy about it.
Oh, one thing really quick. I got a package from Dermstore. I ordered this probably a couple weeks ago. Shipping was quite slow, wasn't it? Let's see here.
Get my box cutter. I always keep a box cutter in the bowl by the door because we get all of our packages. Oh my goodness. Okay, here we go. All right, so I'm gonna open it. I think I just got one item. Oh, two items. What did I get? Oh yeah. Okay, so I got the SkinCeuticals HA Intensifier, which I'm really excited about. I've heard from some bloggers, they call it like Botox in a bottle, somewhere lately specifically. I love them. And they say that it's amazing. So it's definitely pricey, but I got it during a sale. That's why I kind of ordered it. So I'm excited to start using that, hoping my skin doesn't react to it. And then I got this Ulta MD tinted sunscreen, which I used to use. It's like they sell it at dermatologist's office and everything. It's like really gentle, great daily sunscreen, 46, even though my moisturizer already has sunscreen in it, but I thought this was perfect for just like going to get coffee and wanting to throw on some like sunscreen, and it's tinted. So it'll be like kind of even out your skin tone, like maybe just a little bit. I'm excited for that. Okay, now I will come in and show you guys the bedding. We gotta make the bed anyways, we just got up. So here we go.
So now we've got the duvet. So basically I added this coverlet, it's from West Elm, over the sheet, and then I fold them down. Okay, so you get to see a little bit of the beige. Got inspired at Restoration Hardware for how to do this. And then
I showed her a picture.
Shut up, you didn't do anything. Okay, so then, here, pick this up. I have the duvet down here and I kind of just like fold it back.
Create a layer.
Like that.
An additional layer.
Shut up. Wait, pull it down like a little bit.
Yeah, so like she did a little too far.
And I'm trying to act like he's a homemaker.
Right there. And then we grab this one. This was all my idea.
Whatever. Effortless. There you go. Perfect. Okay. So now we've got a layered situation and it's gorgeous. How about like more edge? Okay. Looks good. Honestly, I wish this was bigger, but it's not, so it's fine. We could just kind of drape it over the side, but it's such a nice material. I'm obsessed with this blanket. It looks like very us. Okay, so bench. And this looks just marvelous.
I think we can pull this
off. Oh my God, you just said, let's put it in. Make up your mind. You act so convinced that it's the right decision.
No, I just don't.
And it's like, it's not always.
It doesn't look good. It's not a good decision for the middle, which is the important part. On the sides, it looks best.
So I tried to tell you, no one ever listens to me. Oh, okay, so here we go. Here's the new bedding situation. All of our bedding, we always get questions. As from Restoration Hardware, these are the King Loungers.
The pillows and the pillowcases.
The pillows and the pillowcases and the duvet cover, okay? Then we get the insert from Costco. The sheets are from Costco. The
Costco insert? A lot of people have been asking.
Just a down
comforter. I know, but what's comforter? The second one? What's the model number?
I don't know. I mean, just get one based on where you live. Just look if it's like hot, medium, cool weather, like whatever temperature you need, just get it. And then this little coverlet is from West Elm, and then this guy was in the Amazon home decor haul. So there you go, there's our new bedding, and I'm really liking the beige tones. I don't know what I was thinking with the black. It just looks so much better. So here we go. Okay.
We're gonna go to Starbucks today.
We're gonna go to an outing at Starbucks.
We haven't left the house in a hot minute.
We haven't.
I know, except for walks.
I put the short ribs in the slow cooker. Oh, I should show them that. Mm. Yeah.
This?
My shoulder's hurt. I think it's from TikToking.
Really? TikToking, I've been. That, now that's stuck in my head. Because you have an underbite. And I keep doing that wrong. Okay, so yeah, we've been learning this new TikTok dance, and I got really mad at Hunter the other night because I don't really want to rehash it.
It's honestly because she was in front of me and we were doing the dance, and
you're always telling me what to do with the dances.
No. Well, yeah, I'm trying to teach. There's certain pieces of dance that are dances that I've known in the past, so I'm trying to teach you the piece of the dance, how to do it.
Well, I know. You're definitely better at the dances, but it's hard because when you're not, like, super naturally gifted at dancing, like, you're struggling, and it's like...
Right.
And then he started laughing at me when I did a part, and I was like, I'm done. No, like, I'm done. I'm not.
I did start laughing at her, I admit. I do admit.
And normally I can laugh at that stuff, but I was, like, having, like, a day.
She was having a day.
I was having a day, and I was like, you laughed at me.
I giggled at her. And the reason I giggled was because I was standing behind her, okay? We were, like, dancing and doing the dance. And where you throw it up and you, like, catch it, and then you do the whoa. She threw it up, and from behind, it looked like she was, like, waving instead of, like, catching it. So she went, like... And I started laughing at that. And then she was, like, you're laughing. And she, like, threw a fit and, like... She canceled the rehearsals.
He kept laughing at me at that time every time, and he'd be like, no. You were laughing every time, and that time you just got caught.
No, there was times that I was like laughing at myself before that. That was the one time I actually laughed at you.
But it just so happened to be at the same moment
It wasn't.
Because that's how I caught on to it.
It wasn't at the same moment. The moment that I was laughing before was on the Dougie because I kept screwing it up. It was at myself.
Every time I do this, though, you'd be like, ah.
No.
I was like, I don't know what's so funny.
That's not when I would laugh.
Okay. Anyways.
We're about to start a fight again.
Yeah, so I got really upset. I think I was like, I wasn't PMSing because I'm on my period, but I was like,
I was
so mad. I was just like, don't laugh at me. Like, I was feeling really self-conscious, and normally I'm not. Like, I don't care at all. I'll dance anywhere. Usually you're the more self-conscious one. But you just hit the wrong chord that day. Okay, speaking of, I feel like I've been like slowing down on my workouts, and I'm like, I can't do that, I gotta keep going.
Come on. Okay.
Oh my gosh, you're beautiful. Okay, I gotta brush with you.
All right, we're gonna get ready for the diet.
Come here. Okay, I'm gonna try the new sunscreen it just showed.
Ooh,
so you can see it's like tinted.
Ooh.
Let's try it up close. Oh, also, oh my gosh, I've been trying this and I love it. The Tula cooling and brightening eye balm. Oh my gosh, it is so good. It like, oh, honey, you should try this. You'll be obsessed with it.
And it's nice because it's a stick. I feel like you don't have to get your hands all.
I'm still on my same routine as I've been on for like 4 years.
Avocado eye cream.
Avocado eye cream.
That's it, folks.
No, that probably kills moisturizer, SPF.
Yeah.
And avocado eye cream. I've been washing my face more lately, which I usually used to not wash my face. Like with soap, I'd wash it with water, obviously. But to seal everything I put on, I usually light a match. It just kind of like...
Shut up!
I'm kidding.
Wait, you guys look so cute right now. I'm moving the camera.
You are a model. Oh my gosh. Who even are you? You're so cute. Is that your toy? That'd be... Oh, what's that leg move? Okay. Are you? Oh, good stretch, mister. Good job. You are beautiful and we love you.
Hunter's on the phone with his grandpa and he's trying to help him with something like technology based and it's so cute. Tell me if you guys do this too.
Yep. He's pacing, obviously. Can't sit still on the phone.
Interesting. Okay. I'm trying to... Yeah, okay, so now, can you go back to that sent, that Mary email? Yeah, just click sent again, go back to your sent messages. Okay. So you go to your sent messages to Mary's email? Okay, and then you go to her message, like the actual writing in the message. Yeah. And you're gonna be highlighting like, Dear Mary, you know, sincerely, Rockford. You click on either the start of the email, like the very first letter or the very last letter, with one finger on the mouse, and then another finger on the mouse to scroll to highlight everything. No, no, so think about
what did I push the last time?
You clicked on the mouse.
Mail meaning what?
No, on the mouse. On the mouse. On the mouse, click on the mouse and then use another finger on the mouse to highlight everything. It's next to the space bar.
Does it say, that FN?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Push it down, hold it down, and click the letter A.
All right. Coffee outfit. We've got the famous boohoo sweatpants, white tank. Goose, you want to get my outfit? And my Nikes. I haven't worn these in a hot minute.
So that'll be fun times. And then my Lily Clasp hoops. These are key. Let's see here. There we go, Lily Clasp hoops. Okay, see that brightening balm too? The eye balm, that's kind of what it does. It like leaves this like shine. It's really nice. Claw clip is the vibe. And just my watch, so. Comfy little outfit. And my tan is still on. I applied a fresh layer of tan yesterday. And I layered the Loving Tan and Dripping Gold. And it's just the best combination in the world. So I haven't rinsed it off yet. But anyways, I'll rinse it off later today. I just like to leave it on really. I applied it probably at like 3 or 4 yesterday, so I needed to sleep in it to let it develop, but it's looking good. All right, can you show your outfit? I'm gonna grab my purse.
All right, I'm wearing a blue hat I got from H&M, a blue shirt I got from PacSun, these jeans. Where'd I get these jeans? Joe, did I get these jeans at PacSun? With the paint splatters?
Did you? I don't know. So, here's what they look like. They're like, they have like holes in the knees and then some paint splatters for your like chill, like back, loose fitting kind of. And then I got my brown leather Fry booties on. And that's that.
Got my glasses that have, had about 9 lives. Julie's lost them about 9 times and I continue to find them.
And then I got my David Yurman necklace on and a bunch of hair ties.
I just added this little cropped hoodie, which apparently Hunter says is dirty. It's just a little stain. I need to get a new one, but it's from PLT. These are the best crop hoodies ever from PLT. They look really nice quality. I've had this one since I lived in California, so I've had it for, wow, 3 years. And it's still a good quality. It's just like the perfect sweatshirt material. It's cute. It's cute. I don't want to puff on. Okay. Okay. Grab this shit up. Let's do it. Cute. Okay, are we mobile ordering it up?
I think we're smart.
We gotta go to Hunter's grandpa's house because we couldn't get through on the phone demo. It wasn't working.
I was basically trying to teach him how to copy and paste an email and resend it again.
Yeah.
Which is very...
It's hard to explain.
It's very easy to show.
Yeah.
But it's very hard to like communicate over the phone.
Totally.
And when you're like even saying like highlight a message, like click on the bottom of a message and highlight the whole message.
Yeah.
So you can copy it. Email's already been sent, so you can't do like a command A and highlight everything.
Yeah.
You have to actually use your mouse to highlight it, but I couldn't explain to him how to use his mouse because he doesn't have a click mouse, he has like the touchpad.
Right.
So I was like click on it with one finger and then like scroll with another.
Yeah.
It was
really tough.
They live about 20 minutes away, so we're like...
And we were going to Starbucks anyway, so we're like, we'll just do a little pop-in.
A little pop-in tutorial.
Yeah, they're the cutest thing ever. Okay, so...
Well, I got them to highlight it once.
Oh,
so I was
no.
like, okay, we got to go back and start over and try it with function.
You're
I didn't know which
button did you click for the highlight?
I didn't know what it was Dell. And so, well, I didn't... I knew it was
Dell. How did
Dell.
He copy it?
He didn't copy it. I told him to do control.
You should have just told him to do right click copy. Right click.
Well, I'm trying to teach him the easy like.
But that is so much easier. Hunter, you gotta know your audience.
But babe, he still didn't remember how to highlight it. Anyways, that's what I'm saying. We'd have got off the phone and he would have been. You know what I mean? Like he wouldn't have been.
It was like an accident.
He highlighted it once, but he couldn't figure out how to do it again.
Okay.
And then he was like, "I'm just hacked off. I highlighted it once and I can't figure it out again."
Well, I'm hacked off. Is that a term?
Yeah.
He's probably just like so frustrated. I would be too.
He's no? like, I sent it to Mary and now I need to send it to somebody else.
That's cute. Which Starbucks should we do? Are we doing the one by their house?
Let's go to the one on, which one's by their
or
house?
Or the normal.
Let's go to El Dorado.
Okay. Hey, by the way, we made Caesar salad last night. It was A+. That was like one of the best Caesars I've made in a while.
Yeah.
You know why? Because we had good olive oil.
That was
one of you guys sent us olive oil.
That was a dang good Caesar.
It was delicious.
It's a good cheese.
Do we have? Are there people that live in Frisco? Where's all the Frisco babes? I feel like I want to know the local crew.
Let us know in
DFM.
Actually, you know what? In the comments below.
Yeah.
And
where is everybody?
If you live in a nearby city, and if so, what city it is? You live in McKinney, Frisco. Prosper, Salina, maybe you live up in Gunner or Little Elm, maybe you live in Aubrey, Denton, I don't know, let us know. Plano, Addison.
Okay.
I sound like Bubba Gump on Forrest Gump.
You do.
Bubba.
Okay, we're going to figure out
gumbo,
our drinks.
Shrimp salad, shrimp sandwich.
We're going to get our drinks.
Where do you live?
And we'll show you when we get them. I need to order and stuff. Drive-thru already. You should have just listened to me. No one ever listens to me. It would have been faster.
No.
Yeah, it would have. This is so delicious.
Why'd you send me the caption?
Because I wanted to see if it's a good caption.
But you've already posted that.
I'm posting it in my feed.
Oh.
It's a feed post. Okay, so we did the iced coffee, regular iced coffee, no sweetener, with vanilla sweet cream on top, and I added cinnamon dulce sprinkles and light caramel drizzle.
We got them sprinkles.
Wow. Gorgeous drink. And the Starbucks app is like a candy shop because you go, when you order your coffee, it's like, do you want cinnamon dulce sprinkles? Do you want butterscotch caramel crystals? It's like, you can literally choose anything. It's so fun. Can you move your Yeti? You're king of taking over all the cup holders.
You are.
You're
the queen of it.
That's good.
Make sure your lid is on during every sip.
Oh, that's right. Okay. So we're headed to Hunter's grandparents. We're gonna go help them with their technology, and then we gotta start the rest of our day.
All right, we just got back, and we got some short ribs from the Mexican meat market a couple of days ago, and we're putting them in the slow cooker. I'm gonna let them slow cook all day. They've already been there for 3 hours, and they're gonna be really good, so.
Okay, so this was my thought.
Okay.
I have this hypothesis. You know you're really good at carbonara? Something we don't ever make is mashed potatoes, and I'm like, I feel like that's a dish that Hunter would be really good at. Cause it's like kind of a craft.
It's really weird you say that because I really want to master just potatoes in general. Like making like scalloped potatoes, mashed potatoes, cheesy potatoes. Shrimp salad, shrimp sandwich.
I think you'd be really good at that. Like we should make mashed potatoes, and I think Hunter should make them.
You think I'm like the carb guy?
You're just, that's like just something you'd be good at. You know what I mean? Like I would not have the patience for the mashing, the consistency. Like, you know me, I'm like, probably my meals are like 10 minutes.
My mom makes good mashed potatoes.
She does, so you should get the recipe from her and do that. Yeah. And we could do that with a little salad.
How can we make mashed potatoes differently? Can we add like bacon to them?
Jalapeno bacon mashed potatoes. Get the base recipe from her though, because they're so good. Hers are
very creamy. They're almost amazing. Like, I want to use Yukon potatoes. Like the mashed potatoes. Remember at,
trying to get his toy.
At Bungalow. That come with the fried chicken. So it's good. The Yukon mashed potatoes.
Totally. Those are so good.
I'm gonna
good.
Make those.
High five. I gotta pee.
Do we have the stuff?
You gotta go to the store.
Great. I just signed myself up for it. Goose, what do you got there, Goose? Come here. Is that your bone? All right, it's about 3:15 on Friday. And hold on, let me set y'all up. It's about 3:15 on Friday, and I just had my last work call for the day. So I think it's time for an early happy hour. And I got my grapefruits. Actually, I was gonna do a Greyhound, but I might do my mezcal drink that I usually do sometimes with lemons. I'm gonna do it with grapefruit. Grapefruit, mezcal, pepper, and cinnamon. It's like rare that I like a mezcal. Like at different bars, I don't like mezcal cocktails that they make. I think they're too harsh. So this is like a good mix. And I really like the Casamigos mezcal. So as you know, Casamigos is our favorite tequila. And when I saw that they had a mezcal, I got it about a year ago. And now this is like what we keep stocked at the house. Like when I go to the liquor store to like get mezcal, I buy like 3 of these bottles just to like have on the shelf. And yeah, it's like pretty aesthetic too. I like that it's like old pirate glass. So as you know, huge fan of this juicer. It's our favorite juicer for citrus. And some people ask like, why don't you just use like the hand squeeze juicer? It's like, yeah, you can do that. It's like a little bit more manual, which is fine. However, the hand squeeze citrus juicer, like the little yellow and green lemon juicer, like this, just in case you don't know what I'm talking about, this thing. Well, the real answer, besides this being faster, the real answer is that it's not big enough to hold a grapefruit. So I used to hand squeeze all my grapefruits, just takes long ass time. So, this is like a huge game changer in my cocktail making. Honestly, like this half grapefruit was more than enough for the cocktail, but let's be real, I'll probably have more than one, or Julia will want one. You can see like that's half of a glass like filled. So, all right, so I have all my stuff, basically my shaker, my shot measure, and my strainer. And my favorite glass that I've been drinking out of lately are these beer glasses we showed in our glassware haul on one of the vlogs recently. I got these are beer glasses that we use for just like everyday drinking glasses, as well as beer and cocktails. But this is my favorite thing to use as a cocktail glass right now because it's taller, you can have more ice to it, or just like more drink. Let's be honest. I'm gonna get some ice. One full shot of grapefruit juice, basically 2.5 shots of the mezcal. Cinnamon, gonna add 2/3 of a teaspoon. into the mix. Half a 2/3, which is 1/6 of a teaspoon. So just use the same teaspoon, just get half as much. Bump that bad boy in there. Shake it. This one's important, you shake really good, like more than I shake most cocktails because of the pepper and the cinnamon. You really like want it to mix in to the rest of the drink because we're gonna strain it out basically when we pour it in. So get it as much mixed in, get the flavoring in there. Some of it's gonna strain through into your drink, which is okay, but just trying to get as much like flavoring added to the actual liquid itself. All right, gonna put my strainer on top of it. Just like that, kind of like a balancing act. Well, terrible balancing act. This is the color it'll look like. It almost looks like a Bloody Mary in a way. The cinnamon adds like a brown tint to the grapefruit. And cheers. You can garnish with something, but so good. It's like ideal cocktail. I need to think of a name for it. Because it's that pepper, which doesn't add spice, it just adds like more of like a peppery flavor. Like ground pepper flavor. And then it's ground cinnamon, which is kind of like fiery color. Pepper's fiery. They're both ground. It could be something with ground in the name. Like your grounded mezcal mixed with cinnamon. Like cinemas? I don't know. You got a name for it, leave it in the description box. Best name wins. I'm gonna choose it. It's gonna be the new name of this drink. I love it. Let's give Julia a try. I'm trying to think of a name for it.
Mm. I forgot about these.
Mm-hmm.
You've gotta make the recipe
on. I know,
that.
I am.
So good. It's mezcal cinnamon.
Mezcal lemon. Cinnamon. No, grapefruit, not lemon. The first time we did it was lemon. Lemon's really good. It works really well with lemon or grapefruit. Both like similar flavors, but different.
Something like, come up with like a smoky name.
Well, what if it's like?
Like a smoked citrus balm, citrus drop. Smoked citrus drop. Cause it's like a lemon drop's usually vodka and lemon, but using it with the mezcal makes it smoky. Smoked citrus drop.
I don't know. Y'all help us out.
That's cute.
Out. All right, slight mistake on my part. I drank my happy hour mezcal cocktail prior to the workout.
No,
not a good idea. I would not recommend. That is not drinking responsibly.
It'll get you nice and loose.
Yeah, I'm loose. You don't need to warm up if you just have the cocktail. My pre-workout is a little bit of mezcal and grapefruit with some cinnamon and pepper. It really gets you like ready.
Warmed up
in the chest.
Take a shirt. You're it?
No, I should change.
Oh boy. Okay. We'll try to link the workout below. It's we've been doing the sweat app, and today it's arms and abs, but I'm just kind of feeling like I want like a good cardio burn and need to like kind of sweat versus like a toning workout. So I'm gonna try to do that. Let's see what happens. But it's fine, right? It'll taste fine in a burrito. Is it crunchy?
It's like hard.
It's like hard, I know.
Add water and cook it.
So Hunter's rolling up his little burrito and he's gonna stick it on the burrito. Taco Bell style. It's nice and crisp. Turn that heat up. Yum. Here's my beautiful quesadilla. Got all our sauces. And going to get some chips. Eat chips with all of our dips.
Julia is very kind person, but not the best sharer. Only when it comes to food though, really.
Mm-hmm.
Cause you like portion yours out like perfectly based on like the amount you want.
Exactly.
So you get defensive or protective over your food when someone else wants a piece of that action.
When you're like trying to be good and like only give yourself a certain amount, and then someone comes in and they like want a bite, you're like, that's the perfect amount of bites that I planned, sure.
Shit, I put too much on my plate, so anytime someone wants a bite, I'm like, take it.
Yeah, that's easy.
When Julie gives me a sip of her soda, she basically expects me to just like suck the little rim sauce.
No, I
the
don't.
Rim juice off. And that's like my sip.
Whatever.
I think after this, in the kitchen, quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do that. Wait, you go shower. I know your tanner was on yesterday, but it's time you shower.
I am. Okay. I was going to shower after, but then we're going to walk.
I'm just saying that. You hate me.
You hate me.
I'll clean the kitchen.
Okay.
And then we'll start a show at 8:45 versus at 11 o'clock tonight.
That sounds good to me. No. You have got to get lost. There's nothing here for you.
She's talking to Noah, but normally she'd be saying those things to
Noah.
Me. That I need to get lost and there's nothing here for me.
I think this is too rich. Wow. I shouldn't have eaten that. Shoot. Too heavy.
Funny how you treat me like I'm new to this shit. I've been moving like a